like at 4 years old, I was already doing like really ornate drawings and stuff. And my mom would always tell me, you're gonna be a fashion designer. But I would always deny it. I said, no, I'm not gonna do that. But now I'm an artist, and I actually do bring an element of fashion into my work. So I create my own outfits out of traditional clothing, like Western clothing. So that's also another, I guess, I did end up being some sort of fashion design entry to my work. But yeah, definitely, yeah. I draw my inspiration from my life. So it's all, my work is all autobiographical. So I, from where I grew up, and from everything that I've seen growing up. I was born and raised in El Paso, Texas. So a lot of my childhood was growing up in the border, seeing the culture around me kind of influences my work. What I do in my work is I deconstruct toxic masculinity within the Norteño culture. And by doing so, what I do is I take objects that are considered masculine within the culture, and I deconstruct them and reconstruct them in a more feminine way. I actually go out and look for found objects within the culture that I grew up in. So the work in this exhibition, Transamerican, what I'll be doing is it'll be a performance, but also on view throughout the exhibition will be pieces of the objects that I'll be using during the performance. What I'm doing right now is I'm deconstructing the soles out of cowboy boots, and I'm remaking the sole out of clay. And in the performance, I will be stomping and dancing and breaking these clay heels on my feet. It's in regards to trying to break these types of stereotypes and machismo and what a man should be like. So the significance of the clay for me, a lot of the things that, a lot of pottery in Mexico are made with like a red clay, like kind of like terracotta. So I'm tying it back to that, but also not only that, it's always, in my work, I always include this aspect of soil or dirt. So it's kind of like where we come from and where we're going at the end. I'm very excited to be doing that. I think that's what I'm looking forward to is the performing aspect. Although I get nervous still, I still get nervous, but I think once you're in it and once I'm in the zone of performing, I don't know, there's almost this release and this excitement that happens. And I think that's what I'm truly looking forward to. And also the message that I'm sending across. How toxic masculinity can be and how we're trying to, myself as I identify as a gay male or queer person, and especially of color, being Latino, I think it's very important how these things are forced upon us. And I'm trying to kind of spread awareness about how this is not healthy and how we can just truly be ourselves. I think identity for me is how I am defining the future. It's not about how it is now and how these speculations are kind of forced upon a lot of different types of people. So for me, I think identity is how we're setting the future as people. How we're gonna establish a future for other generations in a safe space. I think it can be a challenge to find a safe space in these institutions. Sometimes, I don't know, this is just me personally, sometimes I'd rather be included in an exhibition because of the value of my work, not because I'm gay, right? So I think that's super important. But sometimes I think that it's super difficult for especially queer people to find, especially queer people of color to find a safe space in these institutions because there has to be a reason for them to make that specific exhibition or even galleries, you know. Safe space has to be created first, and it's not just always there. I think it's important for me to be making this work. Yes, there is queer artists here making important work, but I think what happens is nobody touches subject on the specific nature of the household. Or if they're addressed, it's a little more subtle. I think I address it in a pretty strong confrontational way. I think confrontation is important because without confronting a certain issue, then you never know what the outcome can be. When I perform, I think where I go is into a space that I know that I'm trying to help others with it. So I hope that people take a sense of acceptance and a realization of what is really going on around them, and being able to cooperate and help one another, because at the end of the day, we're all human life.